The challenge for this presentation was to talk about the fetal brain evaluation in only 5 minutes. We'll start with the axial evaluation. The image should be properly zoomed and in strict axial plane. We have as anatomic landmarks the ambient cistern and the cavum septum pellucidum. In this plane, we evaluate the shape of the head and the continuity of the cranial bones. We also identify the coronal and lambdoid sutures, which are our acoustic windows. If we have premature closure of the sutures, as in this case of the craniosynostosis, the correspondent part of the brain will be difficult to evaluate, as in this situation. We have shadowing by the bone. The anterior complex is crucial for screening of midline pathologies. It includes the cavum septum pellucidum, the leaflets of the septum, the anterior horns, the genus of the corpus callosum, and the interhemispheric fissure. In the transventricular plane, we measure the atrium. We identify the perioccipital sulcus and place the calipers at this level, inner to inner. With the posterior tilt of the probe, we'll gain access to the posterior fossa. In this way, we can study the cerebellum, the slightly more aparechogenic vermis, the fourth ventricle, short and wider, and the cisterna magna. We can also evaluate the distal as well the proximal Sylvian fissure. The Sylvian fissure operculization is closely related with the gestational age and is a tool for screening pathology of cortical malformation. If we tilt the probe to the fetal shoulder, we can also evaluate the proximal parenchyma and ventricular wall. To obtain a sagittal plane, we start from axial one, obtain a profile, and then select the place to apply a gentle pressure in the fetal head in order to align the probe with the anterior fontanella. In the mid-sagittal plane, we can identify the cavum septum pellucidum, the corpus callosum, the tela choroidea, the third ventricle, and the interthalamic adhesion. If we remove the transducer from the anterior fontanella to the posterior fontanella, we will obtain better resolution of the rostrum and the splenium of the corpus callosum. Also, on the posterior fontanella, we can study the posterior fossa with the vermis, fourth ventricle, and the aqueduct of Sylvius. If we tilt slightly the probe, we will obtain the perisagittal planes from the sagittal ones. This plane is very important in a situation of CMV infection like this one. We can appreciate the hyperechoic periventricular area and the cyst on the posterior aspect of the occipital horn. It also allows us to rule out malformation of cortical development as in these situations. By rotating the probe 90 degrees, we will obtain from the sagittal section the coronal sections of the brain. You could identify the corpus callosum, the Sylvian fissure, and the optic chiasma. And with a combination of tilting and sliding of the probe, we will obtain all the coronal planes of the brain. Reducing the pressure of the left hand, the fetal head will return to its normal position. At the end of our evaluation, we should ask, was my assessment of good quality? And do I need more information? Thank you for your attention.